Hi guys, welcome back to another installment of Gone Home. I'm uploading the first video as of right now. I expected to go up in an hour or so, maybe, hopefully, I hope. With that said, let's do this. And of course there's a giant loading screen. Okay, so I last left off with being creeped out. I mean, that's the only solution, so let's see. I wanna get in here. How do I get in here? Do I have any notes? Seven, 11, no.
You know that feeling where the first moment you see someone, it's like they have a big gold star around them, and you have to get to know them? Well, there's this girl. I think she's a senior. She's usually dressed kind of punk, but sometimes I see her in this... You know that feeling where the first moment you see someone, it's like they have a big gold star around them, and you have to get to know them? Well, there's this girl. I think she's a senior. She's usually dressed kind of punk. But sometimes I see her in this, like, army uniform. She's always drawing in this notebook, looking so intense. I had no idea how I would ever, like, have an excuse to talk to her. Till I noticed she and her friends hang out and play Street Fighter at the 7-Eleven every day after school.
So I guess this is the guest room. Oh, no, that's just the light. Hey Sam, you're asking what my JROTC ribbons mean. Here is a handy guide. orienteering? Rifle, adventure. No, as many ROTC friends I had in high school, I didn't really ask them about what that meant. But it's kind of interesting. August 31st. Tall shadow in the officer's hall. When I ran its corner, no one was there. How tall was Uncle Oscar? No, I was not wearing glasses. September 3rd, 12:44 a.m. A faint voice coming from the bottom of the stairs. I said hello, did not investigate. Did not investigate, probably was the furnace. Sorry, I just finished eating. September 9th, 1994, 4:11. Poured milk from carton and fridge, it was spoiled. Pretty sure I read that spirits can sour milk. I don't think that's true. Lonnie says she feels a presence in the TV room. I suddenly begin to feel cold. We go to protect the pillow fort. Aw, looks so cute and gay. I like it. Lonnie and I employ a Ouija board as a medium. Disturbing messages are conveyed from the other side. Oscar is definitely here. Enlisted Lonnie to stay up all night and help patrol premises, recording any signs of otherworldly presence. Lonnie reported many sightings, but all remained unconfirmed. Possible ectoplasm in attic, probably leaky roof. Sample taken just in case. Despite our best efforts, we both fell asleep around 4 a.m. All in all, a successful night. Did any of those dates mean anything? Anything important in here? Swear to God, if a fucking ghost pops out at me, I'm gonna be really pissed. Anything else? Oh, that's cool though. I would kind of like a little window like that. I have foil over my window because it's hot here. And now, so I'm kind of glad I went to that room. I already found the condoms in my parents' room. This is vaguely disturbing.
Lonnie brought her hair dye over today. She said, I need to fix these roots. Think you could help? Dyeing hair is weirdly intimate. I don't know if I've touched someone else's scalp before. That's pretty intimate, right? It felt intimate. We looked into the mirror together after, and I expected her to say something about how it looked crappy, or good, or whatever. But that's when she said, you're so beautiful. And she was looking at me. Right in that moment, I wanted to say something, but I waited. And the moment was gone.
Aww. That's so sweet. It's not broken. I mean, probably is broken. Can I hit it with something? Fuck me, that scared me. Hey Sam, do you want to see Pulp Fiction after school at the Coliseum? It came out last week and then Todd won't shut up about it, so it's either good or we can make fun of him for liking it. Have I seen Pulp Fiction? I think I've seen bits of it. I don't think I've fully watched all of it before. Because I'm an adult, Sam, I can do whatever I please. Is there a door there? No, it's just me being stupid. So is there only really one floor? I think I'm missing something. What am I missing? Fuck you. Pause it. This would be... No, not over here. It said mom and dad, so... Can I push it? Where's the closet? Oh, okay. It's in their room. Okay. I'm stupid. I thought it was outside. That's... wrong way. Oh. Fuck me. Ghost Hunter, Sam and Lonnie's Secret House Investigation Log. Hidden compartments found 3. Library, upstairs hall, and the foyer. Evidence of supernatural discovered. 0. So, oh, okay, there's one right in front of Sam's room. Right by the bathroom. Okay, and then one in the foyer. Hidden compartment. I'm like genuinely fucking scared right now. For God. Fuck me. Fuck me. Damn it. To come back. Fuck me, I don't want to go in there. I can't see shit. Let's go investigate downstairs. Maybe there's a fucking flashlight I can use. So, it would have to be... cabin at the edge of the road. The Green Glacier Part 2. Allegra and her scouting party peered down warily through the dense canopy of rustling leaves from their perch high in the forest branches. Mere feet away, sunlight shone brightly off the inner ice walls of the glacial basin in which the forest grew. It was a strange sight indeed, such lushness just juxtaposed with the frigid ice formations. Allegra leapt forward without hesitation, bounding through the high branches. The first mate had been captured by the Green Glacier's Amazonian tribe. His life hung in the balance. "We have to hurry," Allegra's party followed behind, moving quietly as a breeze through the greenery. Allegra landed in the clearing and shouted stop. She saw the Queen Amazonian up on her pedestal, reaching from the lever that would drop her first mate into the vat below. She shouted no and flung her saber at the Amazon's reaching hand, but it was too late. The first mate screamed as he fell toward the water, then splashed down, and all was eerily silent. Allegra looked on, frozen in fear and remorse. She had been a moment too late. But then from the fat, something began to emerge, a head of dark brown hair, just like the first mate's. Then the shoulders and sleeves of his coat soaking wet. But as the figure stood and the water poured down, Allegra saw that the first mate had changed. He was no longer a man at all. In fact, what looked back at her were the eyes, the face, the hair and hands and body of a woman, still in the first mate's clothes. Still the first mate, she spoke in a soft, clear voice. "Captain," the Amazonian queen said, "she is one of us now. She is ours." Allegra drew her magical flintlock pistols from her belt and her crew readied their swords. Allegra glared into the queen's eyes and said, "That's the love of my life, and you can't have her." Awesome. "Sam, there better be a fucking flashlight in your backpack, or a lighter, or something. This isn't funny anymore." No, for someone who just got out of a long-ass flight from Europe, I'm doing pretty well. Okay. 051. Did this one? Wait, what did it say again? I don't remember. Oh, 51. "Gentlemen, Special Shannon Doherty." David Geffen and Gillian Anderson. Wow, these are fucking old ass names.
Lonnie came over today, but everything was different. She was sitting at my desk chair, and she wouldn't look at me. Finally, I asked her what was going on. She said she felt like she'd done something wrong that night in the city. Like I must think... But I said no. There was nothing wrong. I just wanted to say... But I couldn't find the words. I felt like I was gonna cry, but I wasn't sad. She got up and sat next to me on the bed. I looked at her. "Lonnie, do you think you could ever..." And that's when she kissed me.
Aww. Hey, let's go. That wrong way. This way. Oh wait, no. It said basement key. I definitely need to go downstairs since there's a basement. There's nothing wrong added to the backpack. Oh, okay. Oh. Where's the fucking basement? Is this the basement? No, that's the bathroom. Basement, basement. Basement, oh, okay. Now, even though I played this last night, I don't remember if I explored back here. I think, oh yeah, I remember. Okay, I did smart online. Legitimately scared. Dear Samantha, I would like to cordially thank you for having me to your abode for the Thanksgiving holiday with your lovely family. I enjoyed the flavorful potatoes, and also it was weird being around your parents for that long, but it was pretty funny how impossible it is for your dad not to be awkward for more than 30 seconds at a time. Very cordially yours, your close friend and confidant, Lonnie D. A fancy man, quite. Dear Miss DeSoto, allow me to take the opportunity to thank you in kind for being such a gracious host for the festivities at your father's estate. Following the aforementioned meal with your parents, your family Thanksgiving feast was the more enjoyable of the two events. Mana, aw. So they both went to each other's houses. Light goes out, I swear to God. I'm gonna cry. Garden in here? Am I missing something? Am I gonna die? I'm not gonna lie. I know there's no logical reason for me to be scared, but I am scared. She got into the college program.
I'm so stupid sometimes. I was telling Lonnie that I got into my college summer program thing, and I was all making plans like, you should come visit me, stay in my dorm room. But she said, Sam, I ship out on June 6th. I was like, ship out? To where? She said, to basic training. What did you think I was doing all that ROTC stuff for? I guess she's been planning to join the army right after high school since she was like 12. And I guess she's really going to do it. So I was like, after graduation, I'm just never going to see you again? She said, let's just have fun while we can.
That makes me sad. My best friend went to basic training. He joined the Marines. And he left around like a few days before Christmas, after he graduated high school and all that. So it's kind of weird. So I kind of understand how Sam feels. What's this? Mason's pharmacy changes hands. Were they lovers? Wait. Hell no, I'm not going back there. Nope. Nope. Hey. Why is the light on? There's no way in hell I'm playing that thingy. Aww. That's right, Specs. Girl Scout. The band formerly known as Cub Scout. Role model, authority.
Todd's band lost their singer. Todd said he sucked. Lonnie said he got sick of Todd's shit. And he was complaining about needing a new singer. So Lonnie was like, I can sing. And they were all kind of like, you can? And she was like, probably. But she's been rehearsing with them for like a week now. And I finally got to see them play in Todd's basement today. And she's actually really amazing. I feel so proud when she's on stage. It's incredible being in awe of someone you love. So everybody knows it's like a temporary situation till she ships out in June. But till then, I'm gonna be at every single show.
Aww. That's what shitty music to have. There we go. Okay. It's like a drug. The first time was in my room in the middle of the night. I woke up and Lonnie was kissing me. Fuck you! I wanted to read it. How big is this place? Well then, I'm not going in there. Okay, so there's a music room. Okay, so on the right side is a long ass hallway. There's a greenhouse. That seems really cool. There's two parts. Wow. I'm impressed. That's a lie to mom and dad situation, but it was so worth it. The girls on stage were just so loud and real and awesome, and everybody was moving together like one huge... What? kind of sound. Cool thing. Number one, everybody in the hall is thinking you don't know. This will show ya who runs things around this joint. Bratmobile. How big is this place? See the guest room. That's not happening. Okay, so I'm in the hallway. Maybe? I think. Where's the light? Okay, there's the light. Oh, thank God. Okay, guys, so I'm gonna leave this episode right here. I hope you enjoyed it as much as I did. I will see you all next time. Thank you for watching.